Hello students of class 8. Welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidya Bhavan High Secondary School. This video is for class 8 biology and the chapter that I'm going to continue today is the transportation of the food and minerals in plants. And this video is the part 7 from this chapter. So in the previous video, we learned about the translocation and the functions of the translocation and the importance of the translocation and about the minerals like the micro minerals and the macro minerals. And in this video, we will continue with the minerals and we are going to learn about the deficiency diseases occurred by the minerals. So mainly in this part, we are going to learn about only a part of the minerals and the sum of the minerals deficiency diseases. The first is nitrogen, about the nitrogen deficiency. Then we will go for the phosphorus deficiency. Okay, the next is about zinc deficiency. Then also about the potassium deficiency. Okay, and finally about the iron deficiency. So these are the selected 5 parts of the mineral deficiency diseases. So let's discuss with the pictures and how it look like and what is the disease is and what are the symptoms. So let's check. Now we are going to learn about some deficiency diseases happened by the minerals and their symptoms. So the first picture that you can see, it is the red leaf of cotton, and it happened due to the deficiency of the nitrogen in plants. So here you can see that how it look like, how the leaf is look like, how the redness is coming out in the cotton plants. And the symptoms are, the plant shows poor growth and wilting. Wilting means the droop off of leaves, stems and flowers, immature fruits also. The leaves at the lower level turn yellow due to the lack of respiration. Next, the leaf margins turn yellow and later show red pigment on the whole leaf. That you can see, the margin part first became yellow and then it became red. So the red pigmentation on the whole leaf can be seen. Okay, so it is due to the nitrogen deficiency that I told you. The redness progress to stem and the leaves. So the redness that you can see, it is on the leaves, that it will also progress in the stems on the leaves and the fruits also. Next, the shedding of leaves and bolls occur. That means the leaves can be easily shed down before the maturation and they became red. So these are the symptoms of the nitrogen deficiency syndrome and the red leaf of the cotton. So the next picture. So this is a picture of the chlorosis and it is done by the deficiency of the zinc. So the chlorosis symptoms are like that. Like the photosynthesis is affected. The normal photosynthesis is being affected due to this. Then the leaves also turn yellow. That you can see in the upper leaves are turning yellow. The leaves may become dwarf. The first leaf that you can see that it became dwarf, the side area began to curl. So it is all about the chlorosis. The next picture is about the dwarf cotton disease that is due to the deficiency of the phosphorus. And the symptoms are like the plant shows poor and stunted growth. Leaves turn into bluish green or purple in color. That you can see that the left picture is less dwarfed, but the middle one is very much dwarfed, and the right one also. So the some of the leaves become dwarf and they are turned sometime in yellow or bluish green or the purple in color. So this is all about the dwarf cotton.
The next picture is about the calling of leaf tips, and this is due to the potassium deficiency. It is a common picture that you can see outside of your house or in your locality. Like this problem is a very common problem for the plants, that the curling of the leaves, the leaves are became curled due to the deficiency of the potassium needed by them. So the leaf tips may curl sometimes, and sometimes the leaves are turned brown with yellow spots between leaf veins. So here you can only see that it is in the ultimate condition. The leaves are all turned into brown, and the yellow spots are not you can you can't find out the yellow spots because it's all turned brown. It is all about the curling of leaves. The next picture is about the iron deficiency disorder of the plants, that is the lime induced chlorosis. So here the leaves turn yellow or brown in the margins, and the young leaves may show bleaching. So here you can see the leaves are full became yellow due to the bleaching, and the plants produce poor quality of the fruits. So here the leaves problems that is showing in this picture, that the yellowing of the leaf or the lime colored leaf, and that fully get bleached.
So students, I think you understood about the deficiency diseases of due to the minerals in plants. And so I'm completing this chapter with this knowledge, and let's sum up something for you, that the plants have a transport system consists of xylem and phloem tissue that conduct water, minerals and food within the plant's body from the soil. They are taking the water and the minerals, and from the outside they are making the food with the help of the presence of the sunlight, and in the presence of the carbon dioxide they are making the food in their leaves. And the xylem conducts water and minerals from the root and stems and the leaves, whereas phloem transport to the manufactured in the leaves to all the parts of the plants. So the functions of the xylem is taking out the water and minerals from the soil, and the phloem function is to transport the food to every part. The root hair cells are the unicellular thin-walled outgrowth of the epidermis, and which is the outermost layer of the root. So these are the unicellular cells. The root hair cells are looking like the hair follicles, and they help in the absorption of the water from the soil. The water is absorbed by the root hair cells from the soil. The process here, it is happening, it is osmosis. The water is taken from the soil by the process osmosis, and the minerals by the active transport and diffusion. So plants lose extra water through leaves by the process of transpiration. There is a direct relationship between this rate of transpiration and the rate of the absorption, because as the transpiration increase, the absorption of water is also increased due to the deficiency of the water in the stem. Next, the plants require more 17 minerals for the proper growth and development, and when plants do not get essential nutrients or the minerals in the sufficient quantities, some deficiency diseases that can occur, that I already told you in this video. So I'm completing this chapter. I will start a new chapter in some day. Till then, thank you.